Good afternoon and welcome. I'm Matt Greer. I'm the music director here at St. John's United Methodist Church in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Welcome to another Thursday noon live stream concert. And actually, this is the final one in this particular series. We've had a concert most every Thursday in the months of October and November. We hope you've been tuning in for them. And if there are any that you missed, you can find all of them on our YouTube channel to enjoy. Since today is our last concert, I want to give a particular thanks to the amazing St. John's music staff who have made this happen all the way through. Therese McCauley, our assistant music director, Jim Arend, our organist, pianist, and sound guru, Garrett Medlock, our music ministry intern, and especially Nicole Criaturo, our communications and media director, who made all of this happen. Just a couple of things coming up in the life of the music ministry. This Sunday, we are welcoming an absolutely extraordinary concert organist for his second appearance on Music at St. John's. Alcee Chris is coming to give a recital in our sanctuary Sunday afternoon at 2 p.m., and you can come and enjoy that in the sanctuary, if you are willing to wear a mask, of course, or you can enjoy it by live stream at home. Alcee will also be our special guest in our 11 o'clock worship service this morning, Sunday morning, so we hope that you will take advantage of that. As always, these concerts are a great excuse to lift up the amazing work of an organization in Albuquerque with which the music ministry has partnered for over a decade. That's Albuquerque Healthcare for the Homeless. And if you go to the chat box, there is a link that you can click on that will take you directly to their donate page. We would encourage you to do that as you're enjoying the music today. We also hope that you use the chat box just to send greetings and encouragement and to let us know where you are tuning in from. And then finally, in the chat box, there is a link that you can click on that will take you to a printed program for the concert that you're about to hear, all of the information about the music and biographies of the performers. We are so fortunate in the music community in Albuquerque that St. John's has made relationship with lots of fantastic musicians. And today we are very happy to present three of them, Ruxandra Marquardt, Joel Becktell, and Amy Greer. Welcome. Thank you.
Franz Joseph Haydn, which he wrote when he was employed by the monarchs of the Austro-Hungarian Empire back in the late 18th century. And he had to provide the kind of entertaining music for his employers all the time. So he wrote dozens and dozens of those trios. And this particular one has a nickname. It's called the Gypsy Trio. And you probably noticed why, because in that last movement, he starts off with this very dainty, sort of courtly melody and ensemble sound, and then he busts loose and lets the solo gypsy violinist have her way with the counter melody. So you may have noticed, though, that while the piano and the violin were sweating bullets, I was just kind of coasting along, because Haydn didn't. The purpose of the cello in that piece was basically to shore up the rather weak bass of the pianos of the day. The piano couldn't really hold down a bass line all by itself, so it had a little help from another instrument, which didn't get lots of melodic work as a result. So the cello was in a transition at that time from that accompaniment instrument to a more soloistic instrument, and Haydn wrote for both kinds, and that was the more accompanimental kind. Now, we have a chance to play a little bit of later music that features the cello and the piano together. And we're going to play a couple of pieces by the great French composer and organist, Gabriel Fauré. And the first piece we're going to play is a Sicilienne. He wrote it for a friend of his in England who was one of the leading cellists of the day. His name was William Henry Squire. And it's a piece called a Sicilienne, which it was common then for the continental composers to think of the Italian music as being kind of exotic. So this has a little bit of a piquancy to it. And the next piece we're going to play started its life as a song. Fauré wrote it to a poem by Romain Boussin. And Pablo Casals later thought this would make a really nice solo cello piece. So minus the words, it's a piece called After a Dream, and the dream in question is one of fondness and loss, and the singer sings about having awoken from a dream and found him or herself in the real world, no longer with the beloved, and wishing to return to the dream again. You don't get the words in the cello version, but it's kind of amazing how Fauré, having been inspired by that great poem, wrote music that reflected the mood so beautifully. So I think you might still be able to sense the song underneath all of that. And then finally, we're going to play a quick little ditty, again, Italian in style, but written by the person to whom the first piece was dedicated. In other words, written by William Henry Squire. And again, back to Sicily, he writes a tarantella, just a really fun and charming little bonbon.
Thank you. So we are going to continue now with four romantic pieces by Dvorak, written in 1887. And I just found out they were written for amateurs. And it's incredible to me what music for amateurs was written in the past. They're beautiful, lovely, lyrical, very simple, and they're a pleasure to play at any occasion.
Thank you. Joining us online today, or maybe later today or later this week. We want to lift up the good work that Albuquerque Healthcare for the Homeless is doing in these hard times. So please, if you are able, there's a button to click in the chat box and make a donation as you can. We're going to end today with one of our favorite pieces to play. We feel like after this long, long, dry, silent spell of music making that we are allowed to make music with mostly music we love. And this is certainly one of those pieces. This is Eric Zalwin's The Diamond World.